How's it going?
This is
Double Dash Jump.
Jump, 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 jump.
Double Dash Jump.
Welcome to Double Dash Jump. I'm Ben. This is the master of very serious joke, Mott. And this is Jono.
Hi.
Bad apple of three tree.
I'm Jono.
You went too close.
I know. No, don't talk about too close. Too close is never a bad thing.
What are you doing?
What?
Like, having, like, lectures on how to, you know, be professional.
Yeah, but
I like
to get in and personal with the viewers. Like, I want to know that I'm, like, in there with them, you know? Like, fucking in. In like thin, okay?
God.
Well,
yeah.
I'm jinxing you guys, so. So what's happening in the world of Double Dash Jump, my friends?
You didn't say jinx. You just said, I'm gonna jinx you.
Yeah, you got
you gotta actually say jinx. It's too late now.
Jinx.
No, it's too late.
You've been jinxed.
How would you... You'd have to do the next hour and a half by yourself.
Nah, but like... Sure. Like, that's okay, actually. I could do that. I could just be like... So, Mom, could you explain to me... the Declaration of Independence.
And you wouldn't be able to say anything.
You wouldn't be able to say anything.
Jinxed it.
But no one can understand the Declaration of Independence. That's the most important thing. but what a great... We're on episode 6 this week. Can you believe it?
I can. Can you, Ben?
It's been a while. It's getting there.
So this is...
To be honest, I can't actually.
I haven't actually... You know, I know generally a month is 4 weeks, and we do one a week, so really four would have been a month in. And then five would
Christmas
have really
break.
Been a month. Oh yeah, because Christmas break. I don't know, I feel
break.
Like... So we're
Maths
really,
with Mott!
We're really like getting into
moths.
The swing of it.
Moths! I'm Maths with Moths.
You know, you could use my actual name, Maths You, and it would be funny.
Yeah, but you're like, you're already Mott, so just take
I hate you guys so much. If I leave, this is why.
What a great guy.
He's simulated. He's
taken now while he's ready and mutt.
I don't know how to do his
hands fly off like mutt cakes. They do.
What's a mutt? What's a hot cake?
Hot cake.
Oh, I got hug. Hot cakes don't fly off.
Don't they, mutt? Don't they?
They do when you're driving the other... street, flicking them out your window with a DJ through.
Well, I know what you're talking about. So there was news since Tuesday.
When we recorded last.
They don't know when we recorded shit now,
do they? So yeah, there's actually been news. Some news. Not a lot.
Recording.
Yeah. So, do you want to start? Do I want to start?
Yeah, I think you start. You,
oh,
you
because
wrote
this stuff. I wrote this stuff. I was actually, I did the research
Mark
this
did
time.
Some time.
Oh
this
my
day.
God. So, there's, everyone knows about the Microsoft Hololens,
yes.
Right?
What is the Microsoft Hololens for the people that don't?
So, you know how there's like VR for everything else? You've got the Oculus, you've got the HTC Vive.
What's VR, Mott? What?
It is very rearious joke.
Thanks, man.
Okay.
Oh,
for the people who have been hiding under, like, many boulders atop each other, and then the whole area's been cemented solid. VR is virtual reality, and lots of people are making lots of goggles for them.
Like these, or...?
Yes. That's what the HoloLens looks like, I think. I don't know.
What does the HoloLens look like?
It looks... I think they're more like glasses.
Yeah.
I think
it's not a
table that, like, Minecraft comes out of the ground for. It's like...
Well, yeah, no, because that's the thing. Like, you look at the table with your regular glasses.
Okay.
As if they're regular glasses.
Okay.
And then it appears.
Yeah, it's augmented reality.
Yeah, augmented reality, not virtual reality. But it's still virtual. Yeah, I don't know.
Augmented is when you take what you actually see.
Existing
and
reality.
Add all the distorted stuff. Virtual reality
so
is
like
creating 3DS, a whole new...
3DS beat everyone to that, because they had, like...
Well, come on,
at release, they
iToy
had the
iToy
augmented
was there,
reality.
Like, years ago, so, like...
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah,
yeah, that's true. Mm. So, yeah... There's been just a few talks, so mostly like...
I think the most part of HoloLens being different is it's portable. You can take the HoloLens and walk through your house and be like, oh look, the weather's on my wall. It's good. gonna rain today.
You know what? You know how else you could tell the weather?
You could look outside.
Look outside the window.
But this is where the forecast for today,
curse,
tomorrow,
your
it's all the clouds. Instead of
they
going to the...
Closed. That's because there's crickets outside.
Oh, but
instead
of
going
invite
to
them in.
Instead of going to the Bureau of Meteorology and like look at the...
I love it.
You've got a cricket guy?
Sorry. Okay, and so they were saying... so they announced Project X-Ray, which was a shitty game for Hololens, where you like, where they're boasting how you can actually use your hand as a controller or some shit
like
that. But it looks so very bad. It looks really
absolutely horrible.
If it was a game on like Steam, I wouldn't buy it.
No,
yeah.
For like $1.99.
No, not even for $1.99. Steam sale 30 cents. I don't know.
That pushing it a bit.
Yeah, I could buy an ice cream cone of that. Come on.
Yeah.
But yeah, and they just discussed things like battery life. Mm. So it's going to be 2.5 hours to 5 hours. So when you push it to its limit, it's 2.5.
Yes, but if you're going for like a long fucking like...
Yeah, if you want to go for like a Skyrim like sesh of Minecraft where you're just there for hours on end, you're going to need...
I don't think you're playing games with the HoloLens. HoloLens is, from what I understand, more of a universal tool. You can use it to train your little exoskeletons of bikes and stuff. You get like the Iron Man effect.
Yeah,
can you charge it while you're using it?
That, I don't know. They didn't say that.
But I don't know. If you like had the like the cord in your head the entire time.
You're plugged into the Matrix. That's what it is. No, and they also revealed that multiple units can link together over the internet.
So you can see the same thing.
Yes,
on it, like,
it says specifically allowing several users to simultaneously share an experience together. That's
which
nice.
Means
it's,
nice. It's like Google Docs where you can just...
Yeah.
So I guess...
Is that the only thing you can think of? Because you're literally looking at Google Docs?
No, I was also thinking... if you can... if you're playing an RTS...
Go on, if you're playing...
An RTX RTS game like... Halo Wars 2, and you want to play multiplayer, you want to all look at the same map and you order.
Oh, that would be sick.
That's actually pretty cool.
That would be amazing, actually.
It could be like, you know, the war room, like, planning everything.
Yeah,
like,
that would be so cool.
Like,
now that you say that, imagine
watching your banshees fly over.
Oh, that
like,
would be awesome.
Like in Spy Kids 2, where you can see the entire island.
Yes.
And you can see everything.
Now I finally want the HoloLens. Like, if
just
they did that.
So I can
you just...
Microsoft, if you don't do this.
Or like
I can play Spy Kids 2 and watch everything on the map.
Or like a Dungeons & Dragons kind of application thing.
Or like a Warhammer.
Warhammer. Oh, that'd be...
That'd be pretty cool.
They wouldn't do that because then they wouldn't make any profits from selling all the millions of figurines.
Well, no,
you couldn't play all the
buy
toys.
Them figurines and you, like, scan it in. Like a...
That'd be cool.
Oh, Amiibo Warhammer?
Amiibo
Warhammer.
Oh,
my God. Can you imagine those shops, like... like this movie for this week.
Man, I feel like we've just like we
we've
really need a taste
the
of this right now.
Yeah, like, let's get to like
back guys.
The 4K guy, 40K guys.
Yeah.
And be like, boy, we got a nerd here.
We got something.
We got like a really cool idea.
What's the next piece of news, Jono?
Well, how about this? Everyone knows what Netflix is. So,
what's a Netflix?
Oh, wait, did you put that one? I think I put
I didn't put any in there, so this
no,
is
I organized everything.
Week.
Don't worry. I've got it all.
He's going
to
talk.
You've scrolled past the bit that I'm supposed to read.
You
fucking ass. Anyway, so Netflix, the wonderful streaming service, which you can apply for $11.99 each month.
We're not getting paid at all. For
we're not
anyway.
Getting paid at all.
have decided, Netflix and Marvel, they
Had
filming.
Five series,
they had,
but now they have six.
Tell you what. So they've been busy finishing off Daredevil season 2. Season 1
looking
was
so
so good. We've got John Berthnell as the Punisher, and he's just thick.
He was in Walking Dead, wasn't he?
He was. He was the
what
dick.
Was, what was he? Was yeah. He was
he
that.
Was,
dick
he was
guy
the asshole that no one
that
liked.
Was like having an affair with the.
Who's the
wife?
Chick?
Something like that. I don't know.
Like
the very beginning.
Like
I'm looking,
Carl.
I'm looking at Bane.
Like Carl.
Yeah.
Is
there's
it Carl?
No. Carl's the son.
Yeah, Carl.
And then there's the sheriff daddy.
Carl.
all of their names. So there's Carl. Carl.
There's Big Carl and there's Lady Carl.
Rick Carl?
Rick. Yeah, Rick.
Rick's the dad.
Yeah, I know.
Rick Carl.
Rick Grimes.
Rick Carl.
But.
You mean Shane?
Laurie.
Yeah.
Was it Laurie?
Shane.
Yeah, that's what we're trying to say. That's what we've been
doing. And it became painfully obvious that we don't watch enough Walking Dead.
No. Does anyone, though? Does anyone? That doesn't count.
But do you watch enough? Yeah, but
Michael
don't
Bane,
you want to watch more?
Our is that number enough? One audience member for this Sunday.
Actually, have you made us any fan art?
Yeah, where's your fan art?
I'm working on a erotic.
He hasn't done anything.
Okay, so that means Jen's number one still.
No, I said he hasn't done anything. Yeah, so you're number one. Don't cry. Please don't cry. Please don't cry. Don't cry. Don't cry. Jen,
no, she'll throw something at you.
Oh, please.
There's some glass behind you.
That is also a sword behind you. I haven't done anything wrong.
Anyway, so Netflix.
Back onto the Netflix and Marvel are so impressed with John Bernthal's Punisher in season 2 of Daredevil that they want to spin him off into his own Punisher series.
Isn't he part of the
Defenders? No, he's not.
No.
Oh, okay. Punisher's
not the original Defenders. He may have appeared briefly, but nothing that I know of.
In what?
In Defenders. Like, he may have. I don't know.
It was like,
there's a lot of, like...
It was like Doctor Strange and the Hulk.
Yeah, there's a lot of different kind of, like... At one time, fucking, like, a bad guy is in the Defenders at one point. Like, I don't know. I can't keep track of this nonsense.
Okay, so one article which I apparently didn't put in, which I thought I did, was Netflix is looking to
work against geo-blocking?
Yes. Or
whatever it's
called.
There
was two different articles I saw. I saw
VPNs.
Yeah.
One, they said that they want to get rid of geo-blocking and make everything available for everyone. And then the next article was like, well, fucking Australia keeps using VPNs to get around all our shit, so we're going to fucking, like, block them from our service.
If we have a few more shows, then maybe it'll be a bit...
You know what's weird, though? Like, I'm pretty sure us and UK have Harry Potter, but US, like, didn't.
Yeah.
No, sorry. Oh. It was UK didn't have something like Harry Potter. I don't know if it was Harry Potter, but UK didn't have it. And I'm like, but they made it.
Yeah,
it's made in the UK, but the UK but Netflix.
Maybe they've got
help.
Like, you know, British Netflix, like their own thing, and they're like,
Britflix,
like BB Flix.
Stan is a thing.
Stan is a thing, and
Stan is legit Australian, sadly.
Stan is the stupidest name for a streaming service ever, because it's just a fucking bloke's name.
Yeah, it is.
How you going, Stan?
I'm gonna go watch.
Why are you talking to your streaming service?
I'm gonna go watch Stan for 6 hours.
I've been staring at Stan since yesterday morning, okay?
Watching Stan.
Oh,
I just watch Stan from a distance.
I can't watch stand watching this anymore.
Did you just turn up the
right
beer and slam the camera down?
Get out of here!
Okay. Well, yeah, no. So one article, Netflix is like, no, we want to get rid of geo-blocking. Everyone's like, yay, Netflix. The next thing, they're like, fucking Australians using VPN. So it's like, well, make your content available to us, and we won't have to hack away around it, so we can watch your American content.
I mean, do you guys use go around it and try American Netflix or anything like that?
I just download it.
I have.
You got downloaded
before. But I don't anymore because. There were, like, all those, like, reports coming in that using the certain VPN I was using. It wasn't illegal at the time. I think it is now, so I'm okay, because it wasn't when I did it. But then all these, like, news reports came up saying, if you use this service, other people can make it as if you looked at child porn and then you go to jail.
Ooh.
Because they're technically using your internet.
Oh, yeah.
Because whenever you, like, if you watch American Netflix, you're actually using an American's individual internet.
Ah, shit.
And so when
they
do it to
you... Yeah, that's why
you
have to pay for VPN, because you're paying someone else's internet, basically. Yeah. I mean, we can torrent it.
Yeah, that's...
I guess. Not that we promote torrenting on this show.
G'day, Mott.
If
I can't... Mott. I like it, Mott. Off an old pirate boat.
Mott Beard and his gnarly crew.
Oh, yeah.
If I can't get the content...
Motley crew.
If I can't get the content legally, then legally is my only option. And
it's like...
If you're going to discriminate against Australians, then I don't really care.
Yeah. Like, HBO was, like, having a go at us for pirating Game of Thrones, and then we were just like, well, give it to us.
Yeah.
Like, because we didn't... We couldn't get it legally in any form.
Right.
Whereas
unless you paid like a gazillion dollars for Foxtel.
I'm pretty sure you needed. Oh yeah, it is.
You can get it on Foxtel, but you have to pay. You know, satellite installation.
But then HBO's streaming service on their website.
Oh yeah,
pretty sure. Yeah, it was locked.
It's geo-blocked.
So you had to use a VPN, and then you had to pay for that, and then you had to pay for the HBO streaming service.
Yeah.
Just to watch Game of Thrones, and that's ridiculous.
I know.
I mean, you can read the book.
But no one's got the time to read a chapter about someone's vagina. I'm sorry.
Not anymore.
What book? There's no more book.
It happens. It happens. You can't say shit.
So, more news. More Star Wars news because fuck you.
Thanks.
All right.
Thanks for the headline.
So.
I'm really keen about this one. I hope this happens.
Rogue One. Darth Vader's gonna appear.
With James L. Jones!
Yeah, with James L. Jones and the original suit. They've said, the instantly recognizable costume as seen in Star Wars A New Hope has been meticulously recreated to match A New Hope perfectly.
Wait, did they change it between A New Hope and Return of the Jedi?
I don't
know. No. I'm not that big. I'm sure they did alterations and stuff.
No, I'm just thinking maybe they probably used the same costume, but then they just... But at the end of 6, they got rid of it.
I just hope...
And then for 3, they made a new costume.
Yeah.
And then they were just like, well, we don't want to use 3's costume because the prequels are filth now.
Well, not that. I hope they actually use someone who is the actual height of Darth Vader.
Yeah, that's true.
Because it went from, like, David Prowse, who was a fucking bodybuilder in the original trilogy, and then you got scrawny little Hayden Christensen. He's just fucking, I'm not going to be a Darth Vader suit.
So, do you reckon this is before or after he kills Ahsoka? In the new Rebels. Have you seen that? Did you see
Rebels? No. Apparently
they pulled out a...
Did I shared a picture. Hang on.
Kylo Ren sword, but it's green.
Yeah, and it's not all like Kylo Ren's lightsaber is all... What's the word?
Because he's got a broken
unstable
crystal or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Hang on, I have to take off airplane mode, so if I get 100 dings, I apologize. But I'm also not sorry.
Ding, 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 ding,
so
ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding,
ding, ding,
ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding.
Oh, well, I don't have a picture of the sword.
Oh, I thought you were
saying I'm just saying Ahsoka. Who cares about the sword, man? The sword's not as important. She's just super. It's just a sword.
She's just super Ahsoka to me.
Super Ahsoka filled with cat piss?
Yeah.
That's from something.
Cards Against Humanity.
Oh, yeah. That is. Yep. But, yeah, so... It's looking good where I think they're going to build up Darth Vader more. Because we knew that between 3 and 4, he was a badass killing Jedi and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
So now we're actually going to see more of that.
Yeah.
So I reckon we're going to have Alan Tudyk in Rogue One.
And
he's going to say, I'm a leaf on the wind. Watch how I... And then Darth Vader's lightsaber is just going to come out of him and then
just like
slice
in
him
half
in half.
And like,
too soon,
bro. Too soon, bro. He'll just keep cutting until like...
It's right there.
What a great
That wasn't
reference.
Even intentional.
What? Were you trying to call me?
My phone is on silent. You can't call
but
shit.
Yeah. So I'm looking forward... to Darth Vader being a Banff.
Yes.
Excellent. What's our next news point?
Okay, so this is still my news, because I just slammed out the news. Because I woke up this morning and I like check the, I'm like half asleep and I check the news thing and it's just nothing there. And I like, does Ben know that we haven't done anything? Holy shit. Okay. So, and I think you're going to like this.
I do really like
so
this.
So Alien Covenant is so is going
to
be...
sequel to Prometheus.
Yep. Which is now officially prequel to Aliens.
Yeah.
Because
so when
and then
when Ridley Scott
didn't
made
he
Prometheus,
like make a big thing going, this isn't a prequel.
Yeah, he did. Yeah. And then now he's changed his mind. He's like, oh, okay, no, it is.
Because
like,
did he say there were going to be xenomorphs in this?
Yeah. So yeah, because they've changed the name. The name is officially Alien Covenant. Yeah. And so while speaking backstage after a ceremony, he revealed that he's aiming for a pretty hard R.
Fucking keen for that.
So hopefully there's gonna be blood, guts, spooky, scary skeletons.
Like
hopefully
real hardcore alien. You know,
yeah.
Like people getting torn in half.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Good old Bishop.
Yeah,
bit of Bishop action.
Queen takes Bishop.
And just
that was good. Yeah. That was a good moment.
He was.
Although it's probably not, no, because it's not gonna be that because that's James Cameron.
Oh yeah, I know.
So it's gonna
like...
be more climbing in the vent with a flamethrower and then suddenly. Yeah.
And they die.
Did you see there was a petition to change to do a PG-13 cut of Deadpool?
Yeah. And didn't the Deadpool account actually post a thing? Like, oh, I'm sorry, little boy. This is for big boys and big girls. So if you can't handle a bit of adult humor, you can go fuck yourself or something like that. That's
very Deadpool.
Very, very Deadpool move.
I feel like they could actually get, like, Fox could get sued by doing that.
They're speaking freely? I don't think so. Technically,
I just hope they have one of those like.
Technically, you can like walk
Spider-Man
up to a child
scenes, and it's just that'd Deadpool
nice.
Like.
Technically, you can walk up to a child and swear at them. You know,
like
that's not
a hardcore
illegal.
Deadpool
that's
Spider-Man
like,
erotica, yeah. And just Spider-Man going, right. "What the fuck? What are you talking about?" And he's like, "We clearly
Why are you
don't."
Showing me a pic of Axton's asshole. I don't know.
Oh,
what would you do that for, Michael? Christ, what are you trying to tell me?
Okay.
You like to see the real thing.
Yes. Get it up
oh
on
God.
Stage.
Don't. I've already got enough pictures,
We've
Axton.
Already had the penis. Let's get the other end.
No, please, no. This podcast is now R18.
Yeah.
Yay.
I was X last week.
We're going to get flagged.
Nah, but this is the fun part.
Okay, so you know about this.
Vaguely.
So Nintendo had a press release, kind of.
Yeah.
I don't know if they were if it was an official press release.
I think
release,
it was more like
they spoke to
it's
like,
more of like a summit thing that they do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's for investors rather than for general public.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's just like
but
the business guys all get together and talk.
This is apparently yeah. on like basically their Sydney Morning Herald. But
yeah.
The,
Japanese
you know,
version.
Japanese.
Manichi?
Whatever it is. So yeah, so Kimishima says Nintendo
Hi.
Wants to surprise fans with new ideas, not build on old ones. Nintendo will in 2016 release details on the NX. So it's getting there.
Cool.
So Kimishima is then took over from Iwata.
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah,
I'm
he's the
not
next. He's
too...
the next CEO of
there you go.
Nintendo. Thanks. Thank you, Google.
There we go. Let's see.
Yeah, he's the dude.
Fifth and current president
All
of
right,
Nintendo.
There you go.
He's the dude.
So
he looks.
Look at Reggie. Oh, no, that's just that's Reggie.
Reggie's official Google picture is the meme like my body is ready.
It's amazing.
My body is Reggie.
Yeah. So yeah.
Reggie.
Is that just there? You go. So yeah, he claims the expansion to smartphones and theme parks.
Yeah, because they did that
also
whole...
also moving to movies and TV animes via character licensing.
Because
they,
so
gonna...
they did that whole theme park thing with Universal. So
yeah.
Yeah.
And
so he's kind of taking everything that Iwata said that they weren't going to do. And like, actually, we're going to do this.
Well, he's probably easier to be like pushed by the shareholders. Like, I imagine Iwata was like, no, we're not going to do this, but... Kimishima doesn't want to get...
He's probably like, okay, so this is where everyone's saying that we're failing. We're going to sort of show you that...
Who's your favourite animation studio?
Oh, what?
Animation? A1?
Well, Funimation aren't an animation studio.
What about you, Ben? What's your favourite animation studio?
I like KyoAni. Sorry, it's got to be like...
Cowboy Bebop.
Yeah. That's not an animation studio.
Oh, Gainax. I like Gainax. Gainax is my favourite.
Okay. Yeah, now imagine if they had the rights to a Zelda anime.
That'd be pretty cool.
Well, they did do like a Zelda. what, like a little Zelda clip it when they announced.
What, do you mean the one that, oh, when they announced for
Palutena?
No, oh, no, Palutena, yeah, yeah.
For,
so just imagine a whole anime series on Nintendo characters. Fire Emblem, no, the anime, even. Well, excuse me, princess.
Oh, yes.
So yeah, so that's apparently progressing.
Yeah.
So
I don't know that. That to me, I don't know if this. I read something different, but to me that sounded like they're licensing out to use in like crossovers rather than original content.
Maybe, but I think what so they mean like, is
I'd
what
say
Marvel
more,
did when
yeah.
Marvel originally started like making movies. They just said.
Here, Fox.
Yeah, here, Fox, have X-Men. Because you'll only have it for like a day or two, and then...
Well, it wasn't quite that. It was more like, hey, we're going to go bankrupt. Yeah, can you buy our comic book? We need money,
because
Marvel's going to die.
Because back then, it was like,
yeah.
Marvel was just sitting there, like, with moths crawling over it, looks over to Batman and Batman Return... Like,
yeah.
And Superman Returns, sobbing. But now...
It's the other way.
It's the other way. Yeah. Where, like... Although I reckon DC is owning TV at the moment.
Yeah.
I know. DC's got what three different universes on TV. It's got the Flash and Arrow universe.
And then it's got Supergirl.
No, Supergirl's connected to. It's connected. Okay. They're planning
see,
the crossover.
I think it's so stupid that they've not connected just everything. They should have just gone.
Yeah,
and
Gotham.
There you go.
Gotham's
oh,
completely...
Gotham doesn't really matter, I don't
yeah,
think.
Yeah, Gotham. Anyway, anyways, back to Nintendo.
So Nintendo, yeah, they're saying...
So apparently in March, they're getting a smartphone app. I don't know
which
what
that's
call,
the that's the
that's
the chat one?
Chat one, I think.
Which PlayStation did in December as well.
Yeah.
Just did a sneaky release. You can now
but
see like
so,
little stickers of Nathan Drake.
So Kimishima promises smartphone apps with Nintendo's famous characters in 2016. He wants to bring the company's financials to a new level, bring profits to 1 billion yen
Boy.
In several years. So
just released a new wave of amiibos?
Well,
absolutely. Keep bringing out the amiibos.
Different poses.
Seriously, think if Lost Levels was on Google App Play Store and the Apple Store for $5?
Yeah.
Do you reckon they'd get like... I reckon
they'd
get
a lot of money.
Like, just for a port.
Yeah, absolutely. They would get fucking everything. Like if you, even if you put the original,
well
if you, like because they probably put like
I reckon just
the original Mario
SNES
Bros.
Classics on smartphones.
Yeah.
Well, I don't
put them like $3.
Well, how much
pot.
Are they on like the 3DS eShop? Like
I think
what?
They're closer to 10, 12.
Yeah. So I mean, if it's like
but smartphone, if. If you put a
mind you, this is the kind
$12 Mario.
This is like
you
know,
can
the
get Mario clones on the app store.
Like the company that you know charged $20 for a Pokedex app,
which they
yeah
they took away. Bad. They took away.
Took away, but you know, but I yeah.
But yeah, so he said he wants 2016 to be an interesting year with many new ideas introduced in the gaming industry.
Hmm.
According to him, Nintendo's mission is to propel the gaming industry forward.
Actually, did you hear about Star Fox possibly being delayed?
Delayed until
June?
June, yeah.
Yeah, so I really don't know how that game's going to go.
Well,
I just...
Well, it's still coming out in 2016.
Yeah, that's
but
true.
Still.
But the fucking chicken shifts.
But
no, because the thing with Nintendo is every time they've delayed a game, when it's come out, it's been like...
Perfect.
Yes, but
whereas
I mean, there
other
works.
Things like Duke Nukem Forever, it's like been delayed, and then you play it, and then you go, oh, look, all the money went to Borderlands.
Oh, sorry, guys. Or aliens. Or aliens. Or aliens.
I know, it's one of those ideas where everyone's like, yeah, I'm going to buy it. I would totally buy it. And then when it comes out, people are like, well, it came out.
Yeah, but I think it's more...
I,
think
I
it's,
don't really feel like playing Mario, so I'm not going to buy it.
Yeah, but it's more for like the casual folk playing, picking up their phone going, I am not going to buy a $300 3DS, so I'm just going to fucking
but
play
I,
it on
I,
my
I,
phone.
I
so
still
I'm just
think
gonna
a lot of people
pay
buy,
$5
like,
for Mario Bros. And just go on the road and play that, because
yeah, but
that's what it's going to be. I mean, like,
it's almost one of those precision games, especially those old ones, where you have to press the button at the same time, and touch phones are not going to have that level of responsiveness.
True.
And people are going to be
yeah,
like, oh, yeah, great.
You know
it's
what you
port.
Do?
You're going to play it.
Because it's
you're gonna
they'll
Nintendo.
They'll optimize it.
Pay.
Let's face it. It's Nintendo. And the way smartphones are now, you could just movement is with
actually,
and then when you want to jump, you gotta.
It's super. Oh, it's
like,
super.
Like fucking
Matt. That would. I would never fucking buy that
Mario
if it's a no.
Did Let's Super Meat Boy fucking make it to phones?
I don't know.
Don't think so.
I don't think so.
That sounds like a terrible idea.
But I think something like...
Because
it only just made it to
like
PlayStation.
Did we
I think your average smartphone can only have two things like pressing on it.
Yeah.
Like it can only register two.
iPhones and iPads, you can use all five fingers.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Multi-touch.
Shit. All right,
yeah,
well then that sounds fine to me for Mario Bros.
Yeah.
It.
Oh, Ocarina of Time. That would sell. That would sell. That would sell, though.
I actually had an app on my old Android that was a Game Boy emulator.
Oh.
A Nintendo emulator, whatever.
Yeah.
Tried playing Ocarina of Time on that, and it was absolutely terrible. Because,
yeah, but that's not an official port, though, is it?
No, it's not.
But if...
Like, Nintendo would properly optimize it for the phone.
Well, hopefully.
Hopefully.
Have two fingers on the phone at once if you're playing a game, so you can't really play like this.
Yeah, that's true.
Like
that.
That'd just be weird.
But I mean, I think it'd be more for like on the games you can play on the go.
I still don't think that's a game people will pick up.
But I mean,
and
like,
play on the train.
It doesn't necessarily have to be Mario. I'm just saying it could be like any.
Yeah, it could be any Nintendo.
It could be fucking Dig Dug, and you know, like he's just, you know.
Actually, do you know what'd be fun is the Balloon Hunt one where you just tap it and you can
actually punch out on the phone.
Oh, that'd be
see.
What about all right? Now they
That's reviving old IP right there.
They probably won't because they're already doing it to 3DS. But I reckon original Pokemon released on smartphones. I reckon that would sell because they've already got like
yeah.
I mean, you
but imagine. Like,
I mean, you probably played the emulator. You
probably played
the emulator. It's a little slow. It's a little sluggish.
Yeah, but
even
that's,
soft,
again,
even,
that's not an official port.
Well,
that's,
no, it was the official ROM, so it's officially ripped.
An official ROM.
It's an optimized.
I mean, if Final Fantasy VII is on smartphones, like I'm sure there's a way they can make Mario work or whatever, you know.
I don't know. I think they're making too much. Well, I don't think they're making much money off of it, but I don't think. The amount of people who are like, yeah, I would buy it, I think when you put it in front of it and they're actually spending real money, you're probably going to find that not many people are spending.
Is there actually... Are there actual figures we can look up for like...
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
I know Apple are tight, but like... I think, yeah. I mean, it's more the fact that, okay, mobile phones have a larger install base. There are more people going onto the App Store than... You know, going out and buying a 3DS.
Yeah,
definitely. So it's for them to go, hey, have this. Obviously, not the hardcore guys aren't going to play this, but...
But imagine how much better it would be for
the
smartphone
on
users
the train.
To be able to actually use, like, trade functionality with their Pokemon Red game. Like, it's obviously not going to be as good as if they got Pokemon RS.
Yeah.
But
I just don't think it's going to sell as well as everyone thinks.
Yeah.
Like, it sounds like a great idea, you know? And when actuality, when it comes down to the punch and people have to, you know, spend their own money, they're like, $3 for a game that I've got on NES that I can just fire up anytime.
Yeah.
I don't, like, paying to have the convenience of my phone when I maybe want to play it on the train is just, it just doesn't weigh up.
Yeah. I think it's just, it's something that's not, for us, it's just, it's...
You know what this is? This is a difference of opinions. That's what this
conversational podcast.
Yeah, we seem so smart in comparison to the last episode. We're just fucking nuts.
Right, Mutt? Let's see how quickly that changes.
Anyway, so speaking of
Pokemon
Red, Blue, and Yellow,
Happy
so that's coming
birthday.
Out for the 20th anniversary of Pokemon.
Yes.
Okay.
So... We've got a whole bunch of things. So we've got the 2DSs. We've got four...
Limited edition.
Four... We've got the yellow, the blue, the red, the green.
Oh, in Japan.
In Japan. In Japan's got the
green
because...
We don't get green.
Western never got green.
Green we get new 3DS plates of a Charlizard and a Blastoise.
I like the one with the Venus...
That's disgusting. Anyway.
You said it on
We've got a new TCG series called Generations.
And so, we're also getting the re-release of the original Pokemon.
I think that's OG what that cards. Is. That's what Generations is. I'm
yeah,
fairly certain.
Okay, is that what it's actually officially called?
I'm pretty
called?
Sure. And there's also the mythical TCG, which is almost
I now
as
understand
it's
what
a monthly,
these are about.
Yeah. So the mythical TCG, I think, is actually going to be released each month, the same as the new monthly distribution
which
of
the
Pokemon.
First one is...
The first one's in February.
No, the first one is in, like, 2 days.
We'll have this episode out before February.
Well, according to
the
internet...
We've got Hooper coming out in January.
Oh, okay. Hang which, on. Can I... I'll show you this yeah. to prove I'm not a liar.
Yes.
Okay.
So Nintendo was spoiling us. We get a new Pokemon.
Yeah, so it starts in February.
In
okay, so they... Okay, that's the... But we still get Hooper.
Yeah, we get Hooper, but this isn't...
Oh, this is worldwide?
This is the classic worldwide.
Yeah. I mean, this
each
is
month,
more the price.
Australia finally gets Hooper after fucking a year.
Yeah, so... But for 11 months, so we skipped January.
Yeah.
So let's just pretend Hooper is our January.
And how are they distributed?
It's going to be internet.
Yeah.
There's a mixture of internet. There's a mixture of internet and there's a mixture of EB Games or GameStop.
They've not given any information.
I remember seeing some.
Can, just what yeah, so get. It so it doesn't give any information. They're all going to be level 100. Mm-hmm. So there we go. So they're only for the first 24 days of the month, actually. Interesting. But yeah, so I'm going to read out this very official list that I wrote. Mm. So the distribution is... So February, we get the Cat Fetus. In March, we get the Onion Fairy. In April, we get Paul Stanley. In May, we get Nightmares. In June, we get Aquaman. In July, we get Green Sonic. All right. August, we get... Holy shit. September, we get He Wants the V. In October, we get The Shittiest Musketeer.
Wow.
November is We Got Bored and Made Mewtwo Again.
Wait, which one is that?
That's Genesect. And then December is I Don't Even Know What Nintendo Was Thinking.
Yeah!
Which is, hang on, which, yeah. No?
They should have bored.
No? No!
You're in an infinite loop with a cat fetus. How do you feel?
It's Meloetta.
Meloetta. I hate that green thing.
Sometimes orange.
So February, we've got Mew. March, we've got Celebi. April, we've got Jirachi. May, we've got Darkrai.
Which one was Paul Stanley?
Jirachi. Because it's the star child.
June, we've got Manaphy. In July, we've got Shaman. I'm... looking forward to because that's the only one I don't have in my living
see,
decks.
See, I'm looking forward to Darkrai.
Yeah,
for the same reason.
August, we've got Arceus. September, we've got Victini. October, we've got Keldeo. November, we've got Genesect.
I say Arce.
In your Arceus. S.
And
Arce in us.
December, we've got Meloetta.
Came for another Genesect.
Yeah, I think...
Too bad it's not a shiny Genesect. We never got that event.
Yeah, that was
but that's fine. We also got digital remakes
of Red...
Well, remaster of the first three
ports.
Movies.
Oh, yes,
you
we got the blue...
A movie.
I thought you were going with the red, blue,
no,
yellow
so
digital download for 3DS.
Actually, so, yeah, we get Pokemon, Pokemon 2000, and Pokemon 3.
Did we cover the movies last week?
I think
no.
I think we
I think we talked about it because I bought the DVD in.
Mm.
And we had the
but
DVD
these are
on the show.
Digitally remastered.
These
Blu-ray.
Are the Blu-ray. Blu-ray ones.
Oh, on the
4K,
iTunes.
3D.
In your face.
Oh my god. It's 4D when you're watching
Ash crying in your face.
When Pikachu starts crying, you get wet.
Oh yeah.
Well, all
right. So,
get blasted away, you actually see them get blasted
are you like
away.
Blast into your face?
Yeah, they actually hit you. Oh, a cat flies out of the screen and slaps you in the face. So, more Nintendo news because I tried to group it all together. Is Pokken Tournament is actually getting
released
on the Wii U, which we
which
kind of already knew
which
as
is,
soon as they announced it.
Which
yeah.
is strange because in Japan,
thanks.
This is a Pokemon product.
Continue. In Japan, it's an arcade machine.
Well, yeah, so it was always
so
going to...
So, are they releasing it again in Japan for the Wii U?
It's following Tekken. This is
yeah,
what Tekken,
Tekken
does. Tekken comes out as an
arcade yeah.
and then it comes out on console.
Yeah.
That's always what Tekken's done.
Yeah, but is Japan getting
yeah,
Pokken Tournament?
Japan will as well. Because
okay.
there's a very...
It's on the same... It's, or is it a couple of days after Japan
I'd, gets yeah, I'd say it'll be a couple of days after. So, Did you do you know anything about Pokken Tournament, Bane?
A little bit.
Yeah.
So it's gonna be out March 18th, 2016, because
it's ready for release.
It's ready for release.
It was a done game. It's just
technically it's been ready for release for a long time in Japan.
2 years? What? 2 years?
Well, it's been out for a while.
Yeah, it's been out like 2 years.
Yeah, they're still releasing new Pokemon. That's how. It's already released, so this is technically DLC.
Well,
so this is like
the arcade version.
This is
released.
The westernized translation.
Yeah, so there is a post-release edition for the arcade. So basically, someone installs more Pokemon for the arcade.
I think it automatically downloads. Now.
Maybe
they're
I don't know.
Like,
I don't know.
Arcades, they've got the arcade set up to the Wi-Fi.
Our arcades.
I think that's actually how it is now.
Japan. Let me finish speaking. I'll be a second. Then there's a Wii U exclusive characters, and then there is a bus character in this list. All right, and I'll go through the list.
And the boss character comes with an exclusive bonus, I think, if you pre-order. Or
yes,
something.
It does as well. What was your question, Ben? Audience member.
Is the Wii U just going to be like the entire roster?
Yeah.
Yes.
Everything. Yeah.
So there is. You can play as Blaziken. Mm-hmm. Braixen? Is that how you pronounce that?
Braixen.
Which is the second form Braixen. Of Fennekin? Yeah.
Yes.
I'm surprised they didn't have the third.
Yeah. Why didn't they have?
I guess that.
Full evolution.
Yeah, like, I guess you break it up, but it's like, just go for which.
But
I do
I'm kind of glad that, you know, you've got Greninja on Smash Bros, you've got the Fox on this.
I wouldn't be surprised.
No one really cares about the very ugly grass starter of Gen 6.
Hi, I'm a giant squirrel.
I got a shield so I can cry.
No one loves.
Okay, so this is
that was a terrible generation.
This is a fighting game.
Yes.
Right? Chandelure. You can play as the fucking chandelier.
Have you seen that photo?
Big ghost.
I'm the silver car. Late to work.
And it's got like caption. This is gonna be me late to work, and there's a fucking Pokemon battle going on in the middle of the street.
There's a fucking chicken fighting a chandelier. How the fuck does that work?
You can be.
We can put that in post.
Yeah, we can.
Chicken.
You can play as Charizard, Garchomp, Gardevoir. So that's kind of cool. That'll be like a support defense character. Gengar, Lucario, Machamp,
so,
Mewtwo, Pikachu Libre. Which is Pikachu wearing a costume.
It's wearing spandex.
It's wearing spandex.
It's Pikachu voiced by Jack Black.
Yeah. It's.
Hey, you want to play Pokemon?
It's going to be the best character. There's Skeptile, Suicune, and Weavile.
And Shadow Mewtwo. So, Gengar can Mega Evolve. Can
Lucario can as well. I'm pretty
Gardevoir?
Sure Blaziken. I don't know about Gardevoir.
And why did they not put what's?
I think they're still. They are still.
Are you trying to
people.
Figure out Fennekin's final evolve form?
No.
Delphox?
What's
Delphox? Thank you. That's Thanks, been man. Bugging me the whole time.
What's Gardevoir's second?
Gallade.
Gallade. Why didn't they put Gallade in? And yeah. Mega Gallade.
I'm not sure. There's a lot of people are kind of going like...
They've got a lot of odd choices.
Yeah, but you know what? I think that's a good thing. Because it's not as expected. Like, Chandelure... Like, imagine you've been playing as Blaziken and you're like, fucking yeah, because this makes sense because I'm a fighting-type Pokemon. And then you come up against Chandelure and then it's so different because he's actually a ghost.
I do want them to put Hawlucha in just because...
Yeah, that's what I'm pissed about. They've got Pikachu Libre, but they don't have Hawlucha.
Like, the actual Mexican Pokemon.
Yes, Bane. That's also, I don't think that they do.
I don't think that they do. Yeah, from what I saw, they don't. I think they might have a slight multiplier, like a 1.1 multiplier. I don't think there's type-specific moves. I think it's a lot of just hand-to-hand combat.
How are they distributing Shadow Mewtwo?
So Shadow Mewtwo is the boss character.
I think that's playable in the game. And then
I'm pretty sure
you can get you can get a code, which means you can play it early rather than finishing the entire tournament and then playing it at the end.
I think you've got to unlock him in the actual game.
I know in the arcade games, it was eventually unlocked. I don't know about the Wii U game, but after a year of the arcade game came out, they went, remember this ridiculously hard character NPC that you had to fight at the end of the thing? Now you can play as him, and now you can make little kids cry as you defeat them.
So, yeah, from what I understood...
So, but what do you reckon... Okay,
you can get a code. If you pre-order it or whatever, you get pick it up day one, you get special code, so you can ahead to play
it's
a show.
It's an actual amiibo card.
Yeah, amiibo card, and you can play You can verse Shadow, you can scan it and play Shadow Mewtwo immediately rather than having to play the whole campaign.
So Amiibos for Pokken.
I don't think that'll be a thing. I reckon. No. Although it's interesting that they've got like they're using Amiibos in a different way. Like,
yeah.
So I would like to see these as
imagine
Amiibos.
Imagine next gen 3DS.
Hmm. But if you could like say
new 3DS?
Yeah. Well, like, but after that, so it's called something else. Everyone gets one of these because new 3DS isn't a big enough step. I don't think a lot of people are buying into it that much.
No.
So I mean, like, when the next console comes out for
Do you reckon
that,
Nintendo will keep doing handhelds?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. They're
well, I think that's what they'll say. Like with NX, it's always been like NX has always been like, oh, it's going to support both the Wii U and 3DS.
There's nobody else in the market.
Yeah.
Vita.
Oh, yeah,
Rest in peace, Vita.
I don't know.
I'll throw your balls at me.
Isn't Vita, like, aren't they those, like, biscuits that you put, like, Vegemite on?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's Vita. That's the PlayStation
I think
Vita.
That's Vita Wheat.
Yeah.
Not Vita Wheat.
Oh, sorry.
Vita.
But, yeah.
I'm kind of keen. I'm curious. I'm not, like...
I'm looking forward to it. I think
yeah.
it's going to be the thing that makes me stop using my Wii U as a Netflix machine.
Yeah.
Because it's just kind of dried up.
It just sort of sits there. It's
like... I mean, don't get me wrong. All the games on it are good. I've just played them to death, you know? So I'm looking forward to a new... What are you doing? Wait. Why are you...
Oh, you're gonna play
he literally game. Blew the dust off my Wii. Thanks. Thanks, Bane.
Someone's going to do it.
That's... Now it's just going to click behind your cabinet.
All right. And so that's pretty much it for Pokemon news. I think there might be more, but I tried to bundle all Nintendo stuff together.
Are you going to get the faceplates?
I might. Yeah, I've got Monster
cool.
Hunter faceplates at the moment.
I don't have any faceplates.
Do you have any?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't
know. I've got
that's right. You did get one.
I got
yeah.
the big blue one.
What I was going to say before was, imagine a point in time where you go out, you buy an Amiibo card, you scan it to your 3DS, and that's how you get the game, and it starts downloading it from the internet.
Well, that's the whole...
That would be
it won't do
huge piracy issues.
That's true.
Oh, but, no, but it would be more like the, you know what they
well,
did
you know,
with
you
Smash
could just
Bros.
Get a little card and insert into it.
Like, you know what they did with Smash Bros. Was like, you scan it and then you get, like, the trial code for, or the trial download for the old school games.
Oh yeah.
So, like, you scan Little Mac and then you get, like, you can play
Punch Out 5 minutes.
And then you can
Although,
buy
for
it.
Some reason, it was fucked up and it was like, if you scan Little Mac, you can play Mario. And if you scan Mario, you can play Legend of Zelda.
If you scan Sonic, you get a disappointment.
So now we're on to Ben's links.
Yes.
I don't understand why you put that one on there. So yeah. I just wrote Ben is a Rooster Teeth fanboy. I don't know why this link is here, and it's just twitch.tv/Rooster Teeth.
So something's happening with Rooster Teeth.
So next week I won't be here.
No.
I'll be in Sydney for a week.
The episode be up then.
Yes.
What,
you will be
what
fucking
are you
doing,
doing
an episode.
Thanks,
you better be doing an episode.
John. Don't do it. Wait, where are you going to be? Are you going to be here?
I'll be attacking
your
soul.
Yeah, so I'll be in Sydney to see RTXAU, which is Rooster Teeth Expo. For those who are not fortunate enough to go, you can go to twitch.tv/RTXAustralia I don't think you need to do that one.
Yeah, you don't have to do /
mobile.
Well, you can. And
you can if you're...
You can watch the panels and whatnot if you can't travel to Sydney.
That reminds me. I want you to take my original faceplate of Nintendo 3DS, right? New 3DS, and see if you can get them to sign it.
If they
have a thing.
Which one?
Mostly Bernie. That's all I really care about is Bernie. Is he gone?
Yeah, Bernie's gone.
They're all gone?
Not all of them.
Who's not gone?
Gavin, Michael,
what's the fucking point?
Luna.
What's the point?
The voice of Caboose?
I'm pretty sure that's Gavin.
Gavin?
Is it?
Caboose. It's either that or
I don't think
Joel.
Caboose is...
No, it's Joel, I'm pretty sure. Joel is...
Caboose is a man.
Thanks. Thanks, Google.
It's a tram.
The real tram.
My name is Michael J. Caboose, and I hate babies.
Caboose is done by Joel Heyman, and Joel is going? I think.
So, yeah, Bernie.
Joel's confirmed.
Joel.
Yeah, I'm supporting you.
I'd want Joel to sign all my things.
Okay, now, I don't necessarily want Meg to sign anything of mine. I would like to sign her.
I would sign.
With my penis. Yes.
Double dash jump! That's Freddie Wong.
Keep going.
What?
Keep going.
Really?
Keep
going. We have Robin. Freddie Wong's going.
I didn't know that.
Oh, well, Freddie Wong going!
She's not on fucking racist.
No.
Why the fuck are the good game guys going?
Because they've got Australian contacts as well.
No, but they're just lame. Oh, I like him. He's cool.
Adam Kovic?
Yeah, from the old Machinima days.
I don't know. Is it just a thing where you can, like, you know how after, in TV, like after a football game, and they're all like coming in, you just like hold something and like each football member signs it?
I think,
or is it going to be like, do you have to go up to a booth?
I think there's a bit of both.
Just hold up a picture of your penis again and sign it all.
I remember one supernova, like they didn't advertise it at all, but like, so this would have been, I think, 2000 and I want to say, wait, let me do the maths here. 2011.
So when we graduated high school?
Yeah, around then. And I don't think Rooster Teeth was that big in Australia.
It probably would have been...
like, relatively big. Like, Red versus Blue was only up to... the good season.
9 or 10, maybe, I think.
No, like, I'm thinking 7 or 8, maybe. I don't know. Really and hard. Then, like, we just walked past this booth. Was nice. Subtle. That was good. Walked past this booth, and then I just, like, hear this voice, and, like, I look, and then I'm, like, pushed away from the crowds as I just, like, see Bernie Burns. And I, like, reach my hand, and then I actually
that probably
went into shock.
That probably would have been the Hanabi stall.
Yeah. Would have been. It was a very long time ago. But yeah.
Yeah.
So
Hanabi's awesome.
As long as it doesn't put you out, I'm getting you to sign shit for me.
Sure. Should be able to. I'm getting my Extra Life poster signed. It's got all of they've all drawn each other as Pokemon characters. It's just like I'm getting them to sign them. It's just gonna be like bingo and just trying to get them all lined up.
That'd be cool.
Ding ding ding.
That'd be and it would be worth like a whole $50. By the end of it.
Yeah, it's only crazy. Worth like $12 when I bought it, so and that's profit.
What a great deal.
Hey, Jono, do you want to read some news?
No.
Oh.
What a time to be alive! Something about Amazon Prime. Sorry, it's good to be.
Jonathan has not done his research.
Well, no, I don't read I don't read Polygon or Kotaku.
I made it simple for you. I got you the whole, like, the important
part. I know, but you picked a shit website. Okay. So, there is a 20% discount.
Kotaku is better than Polygon.
They're both terrible, terrible news sites. Do not go to them.
Go to us.
Go to us. So, okay, there's the service.
Can you actually, Axton, you can hear him, right? Because his head's, like, not close.
Barely. Barely.
Thank you.
How's it going?
Defines new release.
That's not where the microphone picks up.
I know.
They've got some pre-order discount, Amazon Prime. We don't have Amazon Prime. What? But that's worse for him.
Yes.
So, okay, Amazon Prime is offering a 20% discount. I'm talking. So Amazon Prime is offering a 20% discount for all our American viewers. Fuck you. So there's a 20% discount on pre-orders and new releases. So that's cool for you guys.
Which is very similar to Best Buy in America. You pay $30.
They're still American. Yeah.
Just but shout out to Australian servers like JB Hi-Fi. You could make massive money off of this.
Yeah.
I would. I'm already level 4 at EB, so I don't need to worry.
Yeah,
about.
I'm like.
Cool. So it's a news I can talk about.
Hey, Jono, are you level 4 at EB games?
But guess what level I am on DC Online.
What level are you on DC Online?
Level 0 because I don't play DC Online.
Yeah. All
right.
So
I can already hear like Greg Miller like punching you
Why
through the screen.
Why would you do such a thing?
All right. So okay. So. DC Online is coming to Xbox.
Apparently, it's still got a decent fan base.
Apparently, yeah. So PS4 and PCs are going to be friends because they'll be able to cross-play.
Finally play. This, like, Rocket
How
League.
How good's that? So that's January 25th. Mm. That's and true. So that one person playing this game is probably Greg really
Miller.
Excited.
Greg Miller.
Greg Miller, he's probably so happy he can play on his PS4.
I watched his podcast, he was so happy. Not as happy about watching the Batman vs. Superman trailer.
That was something else.
But there you go.
Was beyond.
There you go, Greg. You can play your game.
I'm pretty sure he's platinum, dude. He doesn't
I
have
think
to play
he actually
anymore.
Got the platinum for that.
I don't think. And then I might look at it. It's free, isn't it?
It's free. Yeah, it's free.
I might look it up.
So you can give it a shot.
There you go.
Yeah.
I can't wait till they do Destiny PS4 and Xbox.
That would be cool.
Except I could.
No, here's the thing though, right? So why don't we talked about this before, like Rocket League?
Yeah.
Why don't you have the Twisted Metal car versus the Warthog, and it's like console rivalry,
amazing.
But
it
they're like
amazing.
Together? Or you could have it if you really want. They should do the thing.
Do the thing.
Where, like
Zuli, do the thing.
Thank you. Where it like. You log into the screen and there's a pie chart split three ways, and it just says PC, Xbox, PS4, and like just how many goals they've done.
And there's just like a crumb
and,
in the corner.
And PS4 is just dominating because it's had like 12
yeah.
months.
So PS4, like PC, and then just tiniest little for Xbox One.
It's like 0.0001%.
Yeah.
Well, no, zero because they haven't even released it for Xbox yet. But yeah, no.
Cool.
PS4 and PC are doing a lot of cross compatibility and
Xbox One. I'm just imagining
they've
when,
done it for a long time.
I'm imagining when Portal 3 comes out, we can do the same thing that we did with
Portal 2. Yeah.
No. Apparently, Bane, the lead editor of Valve, says no.
Oh, thanks.
You're just shaking your head like viciously.
Thanks, Gavin.
There will never be a Portal.
Shut the fuck up, Axel. I believe.
I love Portal 2, man, but there will never be a Portal 3.
There'll be.
It will be Left 4 Dead. 3.
No, they'll do Left 4 Dead 4.
Oh, yeah, because
right.
Evolve is Left 4 Dead 3. I think this was. I put this in just because it's another 2S PS2
port
with trophies and 1080.
Oh, actually, they announced, what was it, Dark Cloud 2.
Yeah, they did
so
announce
that.
That's not what this link is.
But
it's Ark the Lad, Twilight of the Spirits.
Yeah, I don't get that title. Is he a lad named Ark? I don't. I've never played this.
Oh,
game.
Neither have I.
But I was reading the comments of this, and someone was like, "Why fucking bother with this? I've got a PS2." And then the rebuttal comment just slammed them down. Says like, "Oh yeah, so your PlayStation 2 version runs on 1080p, like 30 frames per second with trophies, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sick bun, boys.
Again, which games would you like to see come from the PS2?
Persona 4. Final Fantasy 12.
Get out.
I'm fucking in my house.
Oh, yeah.
Spyro
would be good.
Spyro, Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah.
Kingdom Hearts. I've got the whole big fucking pile of PlayStation 2 games.
Let me just quickly. I'm gonna quickly. Hang on.
We're gonna run.
I'm gonna.
What else would I want?
I'm gonna shout.
I want Shadow of the Colossus needs to be on.
What about Turok Evolution? Nah. What are you looking for?
Wait,
does Shadow of the Colossus or?
No.
I want Shadow of the Colossus.
Oh, what about like
Shadow of the Colossus?
What about Jack 2, Ratchet and Clank? Lego Indiana Jones.
No.
The of
going back, let's
Where
get
the fuck
Lego.
All these games for you.
Crash Nitro Kart.
Yes.
Yay. Crazy Taxi.
Not that. Yes.
No.
I said yes.
Yes.
I don't know if.
It'd be terrible.
Can they?
Oh.
Axton, is it this any of this getting picked up from
yeah,
being yelled?
It will be.
It will be.
Me, but it'll just be a bit faint.
All right. Well.
But yeah, that's just my quick.
What about Tomb Raider?
If they brought PS1
pyramids?
Games as well.
No, that's so that's it's, PS1.
Yeah, the
so
PS1.
That would be
Tomb Raider Legend.
If you
want to
play that, you'd
Tomb
have
Raider,
to play
Tomb Raider
PS
Legend
TV.
Was good. I'd play Tomb Raider
PS3.
Yeah,
PlayStation.
PlayStation also.
If they
PS4.
Did a good thing of that, it would be good.
Cinema Love.
Ooh,
yeah,
I actually
good
didn't
good
get
game.
To play that one that much.
Good game. Thanks, Michael.
Shut the fuck up, Bane.
What? Was there... I might be thinking of Sonic, but is there a Crash Bandicoot game where he turns into like a werewolf?
No, it's Sonic.
I think that's Sonic.
I know that it is also Sonic, but I think there's a Crash Bandicoot game that does that.
Maybe. No.
Just every Crash Bandicoot.
Bandicoot. Oh, wow. That was insane.
Classic Mark.
Mark and his absolute crazy scheme.
Anyway, yeah, every Crash game. Thanks.
Well, I don't think Ratchet and Clank will make it because that got ported to PS3, and they've already got trophies.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Well, they
can
just re-release it because it's already a 1080p and
well, the Vita version, it definitely isn't. Oh my god, the Vita version is terrible.
Yeah.
Who released that? Who thought it was a good idea to release it for Vita?
I don't know what other PS2 games, yeah.
EA is still pushing Origin.
Yeah. Instead of just
they think it's so successful that
apparently it is. Because a lot of people play sport games and apparently a lot of people
because it's literally forced upon them. Like, if you want to play this game, you have to
get Origin.
There's a lot of people who like Sims and there's a lot of people who like sports games.
Battlefield.
Yeah, Battlefield.
And a couple of shooters.
And, you know... Oh, there you go. Dragon Age Inquisition. Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. That was like Game of the Year, wasn't it?
That was... I'm pretty
sure... Garden Warfare 2
is coming out. And I'm pretty sure we got number one for free earlier last year.
Oh, we did too.
It got completely free. So,
you know
I don't even need to buy Origin. I got it for free.
You know what the saddest thing is?
What?
Garden Warfare? It's actually a really fucking good game. It's like really good.
That's why it was Game of the Year.
It's actually really good. If we get Garden Warfare 2 for free, I'm definitely playing.
Yeah. Oh, no, yeah. I'd like to play it. Put your hand down.
So, EA thinks it's cool enough to be PlayStation Plus and
it's
Xbox Gold.
It's cheaper,
and so they're having Origin access.
So I know,
is it just on PC, or
Yes. So, by doing this, you can get pre-release trials of upcoming games, and you can get to
play
the vault.
FIFA 2018.
Oh, well, no, because, they've got, so it's the same as EA Access, okay.
Yeah.
And apparently you get 10% discount on all purchases. Mm. So, this actually sounds like one of the things that may be worth it,
If you play a lot of... If you play a lot of Sims or sports games or Battlefield.
That would be pretty good. Imagine, you'd only have to spend $900 on the Sims instead of $1,000.
Yeah,
pretty much.
No, don't draw on that. Don't draw on that. I'm keeping that. Don't draw on that.
Or, I imagine they'll do some Battlefront stuff through there or something. Maybe. Well, they've got that new one, the adventure game, the Star Wars adventure game that's meant to be coming out at some point. I think it's like the next one. It's by the Dead Space guys. The Dead Space guys are working on a high mod.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, it's a bit risky.
So, what Axton is passing around, he's got a little note here saying, EA just announced Plants vs. Zombies Black Crops.
Oh.
That's good. I'm just imagining, there's a flower and it's just got robotic leaves.
What?
You see
what are the seeds, mate?
it's got the, Titan ability plants.
Yeah.
I think this one's more for me and a couple of other people. Clash of Clans.
Oh, Clash of Clans. All
right. Let's get going, guys.
What? What's happening?
Wow. So, yeah, there's a new update for Clash of Clans. There's a new star bonus, which if you win 5 stars in multiplayer in a day, you get extra loot. I know, because I think I'm the only one who plays Clash of Clans here, possibly.
Probably. Also...
He plays mine as well.
Oh.
I have an alternate account.
So you're, the only person in this entire suburb that plays the game.
I don't know if I'm in...
People get really into it, I'm just not.
Mm.
I got really into it. I spent a lot of money on it, too.
I haven't
really?
Really?
How much did you spend?
Probably
Wow, $70.
I have a really bad habit of spending money on in-game purchases.
I've played for about 4 years, and I think I've maybe put in like $2.
Oh God!
I gave them $5, and the biggest hug you'll ever see.
I'm really impatient. I can't be fucking waiting until I don't play those games anymore.
I think so.
There's a new treasury which is housed inside your clan castle. You get its safest places to store your resources. Whoa. So people raid you, you're not going to get all your stuff stolen.
But it's not 100% safe.
No, but it's safer than keeping it in your storages, ironically. And there's also a loot cart. So after your village has been attacked, a percentage of what you lost is actually given back to you. That's it.
That's interesting. That's an interesting game mechanic. Yeah. You've got insurance in your game. That's interesting. Like, I think that's the first time I've ever heard of insurance in a game.
You should get insurance if you buy an EA game.
No, in Sims as well, you get insurance.
Really?
If your shit burns down, they're like, so this cost $50, we're giving you 20. Yes.
You've got car insurance in Grand Theft Auto
Online. Oh, yeah, you do too. Shit, you do. That's true.
You do too.
Wow. Games are becoming so much more mature.
Next, we're going to have to do tax.
Yeah, just like Grand Theft Auto 5, have to go to the like taxation office.
No, that's actually confirmed for Grand Theft Auto 6.
Yeah.
So you have to file a tax return every.
Where did you get this $1 million from?
Apparently, we could burn our babies inside houses like in The Sims. Then we'd be that much closer.
Yeah. Oh, how more interesting would Sims be if you got life insurance?
They kill off your character just for.
You can do that. You can unlock like a lifetime reward where you spend like 30,000 lifetime reward points to get like a mysterious relative suddenly dies and you inherit like 30,000.
Oh yeah, I remember that one. Or like.
Also, you can actually do it like if you have like you play a character and they die and you play as like another character who's actually like good friends or related, then you inherit part of their.
That's cool. There is an aspiration. There's an aspiration that you can get where you like kill 5 husbands or something like that.
Yeah, that's in.
That's what I want to do.
Yeah, the fourth one, and you just like.
That's what I want to do.
Oh, they just fell into the pool right when the renovators came in and put walls around the pool so he couldn't get out.
And the oven just caught fire on the carpet.
It was all so messy, and the. Very coincidental. Anyway.
The ladder from the pool disappears.
Oh.
Where'd it go? Have you seen that video? It's like if Sims was a horror movie. And they're just like, where'd the ladder go? Oh, God.
Why is there no door?
Moving on.
Some sad news for GameStop.
They continue to suck dick.
That's what I wrote. I just wrote suck dick GameStop.
So, in Puerto Rico, there's government tax on top of regular tax.
And, like, probably, I'm imagining, like, importing tax. I don't know.
Import tax, I'm not sure.
It sounds like there's just a lot of crap and tax and things getting
Did Tony Abbott go to run Puerto Rico?
Must have.
So, basically, the massive amount of tax is making it
harder.
Pretty much impossible to make any profit in stores to run your company. And so trying to keep the same prices for Puerto Ricans as maybe the rest of America is just not viable business.
Well, and anyone think of the Puerto Ricans?
So, yeah.
Wow.
There's a
maybe
bunch of
PS Plus will. I don't know.
Game.
Wait a minute.
And so GameStop is... Please no. All GameStops across Puerto Rico are shutting down, and this could be a warning for Australia.
Yeah, because isn't EB Games owned by GameStop?
Yes.
So that's
it's a subsidiary.
Subsidiary.
So I mean, if you want to have a look at how bad tax is, look at our import tax for alcohol.
Actually, also in Brazil, they've got like 150% tax
on
video games. So it's like if you're buying a PS4, it's like $1,500.
Far out.
In Brazil. So Yeah, like the South American countries.
But I hear that waxing your vagina there is cheaper and easier.
Thanks, Mark. What
the fuck? Where it got its name from?
Do they tax your vagina as well? Tell me that, Mark.
Australia does.
They do.
If you're a female, tell
me. They
do. Where, how do they tax your vagina?
Like tampons and pads.
Yeah.
Dickhead.
I'm paying, okay.
Sanitary items for women are taxed as opposed.
You know what, Jono? I'm sick and tired of your misogynistic views.
God, that fucking white boy.
Can you fucking stop? Shall we move on?
Move on, please.
I love how this is
that
all three of you are like so intently like staring at me and like literally pointing your fingers at the camera.
We have a cameraman that's a girl. That's, yeah.
No, our entire viewer base is Jen. So
John, actually it's camera person.
Aww.
You can only get policemans, can't you? Oh my god. Don't forget the monthly menstruation tax.
Yeah. But we brought that up, didn't we?
What?
There isn't one, don't worry. Not yet.
Basically.
Don't vote for Bane.
Yes, because white males don't have enough. Oh no.
You must pay for
the You know what? Still better than Donald Trump, so
but you
did you see the new they had David Bowie, age 69, Alan Rickman, age 69, Donald Trump age 69.
Come on, God, Do it.
Well that's news that we don't have in there. Rickman died.
And
David Bowie.
And we didn't talk about that.
And David Bowie.
Because it was too
Yeah.
It's too
That's
sad.
A tragedy. But David Bowie's. But David Bowie. So, David Bowie. World without David Bowie.
I'd say a moment of silence, but as a podcast, that's kind of really stupid.
So, a moment of silence. Okay.
Moment's over. <All right.
laughs> Moment's done.
What?
What?
Are you? Do you actually want to have a moment of silence? And you're I can actually
over.
Time it, guys.
Exactly.
But see, this.
Well, we're all mathematicians
it's a,
here.
It's a show
we can
about
figure
talking. We need to talk. If you want, at the end, we can go outside and all raise our wands up and destroy
they
the dark
that,
mark in the sky.
They did that at the court.
I'm still sad I couldn't go to that.
See, my thing would be doing the Metatron from Dogma, so he's just got
yes.
Parts. Because angels don't have genitals, guys.
They do in Supernatural.
You need to watch Dogma. Go and watch Dogma.
All right, next piece of news.
So Star Wars 8 turns to the dark side. John Boyega has said that it's much darker than 7. So you know what that means?
There's going to be two black eyes.
He made the joke, not me this time.
So everyone knows that Star Wars 7 was like an exact copy of Star Wars 4.
Exactly.
So
not
this is
spoilers.
Confirming that 8 is just going to be a copy of 5. Because 5 was darker than 4.
Too bad 5 was the best Star Wars movie in the whole thing.
Yeah. Oh, because 7 was like a copy of 4, but I reckon, personally,
I think
it was better. But do you reckon if 8 is a copy of 5, do you reckon 8's going to be better than 5?
So 9,
they
we're going to get...
They find Han Solo at the bottom of the reactor and they just shove him back into carbonite?
Yeah.
Well, I don't think it could get any worse.
Well,
do you reckon, who do you reckon's gonna die?
Hang on. This means episode 9. We should at least get Ewoks back.
No, I'm still okay. No. I'm still looking.
Or it's just like
for a Gungan.
Or it's just like the Disney Channel shows up because. I am Lady Cyrus.
Oh God.
Yeah.
No.
I heard that the next film's not gonna be done by J.J. Abrams.
No, it's not. It's done by someone else.
Ryan Johnson.
I think. Of Georgie Boy is coming back for a bigger role in directing.
No.
Oh, yeah. No. It was someone said that they wanted George to come back.
They had a petition
and
to
I
get George
said
Lucas.
No.
Yeah, please don't do that. So it's Rian Johnson and then Colin Trevorrow.
I've never seen anyone fuck up something they've already created as much as George Lucas. Like, not only did he make Gungans... But
did you see
he changed the original?
There was an interview during the week where the actor who played Jar Jar Binks brought up that he basically cannot ever return to Star Wars. But, like, personally, he just cannot face it because there's just so much backlash against Jar Jar Binks.
Well, did he not just realize that when he was, like, doing it? Did he not
realize?
No, guys, I think
this was his response. He was like, as an actor, I put all of my personal, like, he put all of his actual energy and emotion.
I feel really bad for him.
And it's like, he personally took it to heart when everyone took Jar Jar so badly.
Well, it's obviously not the actor as much as it is the script. And the immediate description.
That out, you should have some questions, like.
Yeah, you should be like, yeah, like, George. This
Mr. Jar Jar Binks, we've got to fix this, man.
Yeah,
I think that.
Do you know what would be worse if George hadn't have written that and he had have like suggested that himself? I think Jar Jar should sound like this.
Wow, if he was like responsible for Gungans being the way that they were, then we could all just hate him, and we wouldn't have to hate George anymore.
Could you imagine a world where Michael Jackson had actually gotten the role of Jar Jar Binks? And we. Because don't you know? Okay, Michael Jackson.
I'm just thinking about how brilliant this would be.
Michael Jackson, for those that don't know.
Hey, Mr. Jar Jar Binks!
Is that not what it would be?
Oh, yeah, you okay.
Are you okay? No, no. Annie, are you okay?
Annie, are you okay?
You spin stuff.
You spin. It's a thriller.
It's so close to midnight.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Lisa didn't touch that child.
No, just like Jar Jar Binks appears, and then Qui-Gon's just like, stay the fuck away from the child.
Don't suicide.
Yeah, that's the real reason Annie went to the dark side. Do you not want to say that?
Oh,
like, I mean, we've only got 10 minutes left, apparently.
Yeah, because
that's hilarious, though.
Survival Island 3.
Yeah.
Australia story.
It's a 3D game. I think
this is only on iOS, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's an iPhone game.
Imagine if this was VR.
And so it's a survival, like, you know, you're in the Australian outback, you got to fight crocodiles and kangaroos, and you got to hunt to survive, and you got to make shelter, and you have to watch out for Aboriginals, and you have to kill Aboriginals in this game. Well, so there is a screen cap of the game that we're looking up, and that we'll put up that just says, "Beware of Aborigines," and they're like the character, the player is in a shelter, and out the door there's like two or three Aboriginals coming at him, and so this is a fucking hate crime of a game.
It's rated 12 plus by Apple. How did this get? Apple has such a strict policy on rating their apps and going through their apps. How did this manage to get through Apple's fucking fishnets?
Well, considering like the 80 Pokemon clones that make their way into the App Store, I'm sure someone was just like,
"Did someone?
No one in America is going to know what an Aboriginal is. Let's just put it through anyway." But
yeah, maybe.
Well, I mean, what's the difference between GTA and running around killing black people in GTA?
I don't remember a sequence in GTA where flashing on the screen, beware of black people.
Yeah, you can't.
Like,
have that.
well. Yeah, I've been to Grove Street. Home. Or at least it used to be before I fucked everything up.
So, yeah.
San Andreas opening. No. Yeah. Thank you.
Fucked it up, CJ.
All we had to do was follow the damn train.
So,
yeah.
You run around trying to survive and watching out for the Aboriginals that try and attack you.
Already about the game?
No, the book basically sounds very much like this game.
Yeah.
So, what I'm really surprised by is this happened in history.
Yeah.
The English came to Australia.
Well, you know what?
And slaughtered Aboriginals for fun.
Yeah, and I think...
That's pretty much the English history. Creed. Wherever they went.
Except for New Zealand.
Except for New Zealand.
The Maori's a treaty because they were scared of the Maori.
See, but here's the thing. Here's the thing, right? People think white people are racist because we do this. But we did that to ourselves as well. We just went, oh, hey, France, how you going? You got a nice... Fuck you, you're all dead now.
Germany did that all through World War I.
Yeah, and Russia didn't even do it. They didn't even bother going to another country. Russia was just like, fuck it, I'm killing myself.
Yeah.
They still do that.
Yeah, so, but I mean...
Yeah, it is, like, historically factual, but it's... I don't think that makes it...
Appropriate.
It doesn't make it right.
No, it's not... I'm not saying that it's appropriate or right. I'm saying that... I guess... Are people just shocked that they're being told that this happened? Like, I...
Why are they surprised?
Well,
because... Like, it's something that happened.
But a lot of people outside of Australia don't realize that that's Australian history.
That's true.
We hush it all up, but it really is just... No one gives
well, I mean, we don't do it China and, you know, block everything about the Tiananmen Square. Yeah.
China blocks everything about the Tiananmen Square.
That's what I'm saying.
So does Turkey with the Armenian genocide.
Yeah.
And
so does Germany with the Jewish genocide.
Mm. Well, I think they've changed that now.
Germany's changed a bit.
Yeah, but Germany, if you did the Nazi salute, you would go to jail at a point in time. Mm.
I think you would still go to jail.
You probably would. I don't know the laws at present, unfortunately. I haven't been studying the German laws.
I'm not surprised that it got onto the Google App Store because everything fucking makes it onto the Google App Store.
You mean
America with 9/11?
Oh, ooh. We just hit that.
Ooh, snap.
So, this game is terrible.
Yeah, it looks terrible to, like, begin with. You know what would actually make... I did look at this, and I looked at gameplay, and I was thinking it would be actually an interesting game if you weren't some random white dude that showed up on this island, but you played as an Aboriginal. And then it wouldn't be racist when you kill other Aboriginals because tribes do compete.
I don't think there's a way to justify that.
I'm not saying justifying genocide. I'm saying just justifying murder.
Well, I don't think this is even genocide.
Murder's okay. Just don't be racist. That's fine. Don't kill specific people.
I'm gonna get that tattooed on my baby.
Okay. I have to read.
I'll be like, Matt 2016. So
yeah, Matt 2016.
Just fucking kill people.
Just kill people, alright? Just like when I'm playing GTA, I just go onto the sidewalk. I don't go, oh, it's fucking Miranda taking her down.
My kid will
I
be
just
like,
mow them all over.
My kid will be like, in the playground.
I don't think you're making this any better.
I know, I'm not.
So bottom line, this was a terrible idea for an app. I don't know how it got through.
So
Apple's, you know.
We're gonna make bets to see when it'll get taken down.
And I'm pretty sure it's already taken down.
I'm fairly certain it's gone.
Yeah. But at the same time, I'm surprised that people are horrified at
it. As horrified?
Like.
But I mean, I imagine it's like.
I mean,
from now, Apple will at least.
Well, Apple should have been doing that forever.
Should have done it. Should have already done it, but they'll reevaluate.
To the audience member.
What about hatred? No, that was a big uproar when Android released.
What's hatred?
You know the.
So that did its work. I mean, no idea what it is. Wow.
What was it, 50 cents?
Do you mean like when Pandora opened the box and Hatred came out?
No, like the game.
Thanks.
What?
Thanks for that whimsical history lesson.
No worries.
I mean, the same thing happened when 50 Cent released his game Black on the PS2.
What was that?
I thought it was called 50 Cent.
I'm pretty sure.
How much did it cost?
I'm not sure.
Did it cost 50 Cent?
Did you just Google Black and there's just four images of Black?
What were you expecting?
Yeah, I don't know what I was expecting.
So the title for this episode will be Our Most Controversial Episode Yet. Listen to the end.
Okay, maybe it wasn't 50 Cent.
We went from
50 Cent.
Yeah, we've done
racism.
No,
sexism. 5 days.
I don't think we said anything bad.
It was implied.
Yeah, this is a terrible game. Shouldn't be online. Surprised people are as outraged as they are, is my personal takeaway. Like, I mean, there's lots of terrible games. I mean, we did have a pause in the middle.
You know how...
There's a lot of terrible content online. I mean, there's Turkish, like, pranks where they pretend to be terrorists and shoot at buses and stuff.
Oh,
I mean,
that's good.
That's, you know, there's tons of terrible content online. And for this to get as much attention as it kind of did is, I don't know. For me, it seems a little disproportionate.
I don't know. I feel like it's got the same amount of attention as that game that literally put you in a school shooting. There was a game that you're the shooter in a school shooting.
There was also the CSGO.
And so this has got about this...
was it called
just
School Shooting Simulator?
I don't know. I don't know what it's called. But it's got I feel like it's got the same amount of traction as that.
Well, I mean, there's the same controversy as when someone used CSGO and they used the map builder to make their own skill.
Yeah,
actually,
right.
To divert the conversation just quickly, we had that Rick and Morty game come out on the App Store.
Did we talk about this last time, buddy?
Did we?
Yeah, we
I think we mentioned it was coming out. And then,
Is it out? It's actually out now. It's out.
And there's a lot of screen grabs on Reddit.
Yeah,
because everyone thinks it's funny.
It's funny.
Because it is funny.
You can get a Hammer Morty.
Hammer Morty.
It's nice.
That's right. That's really great.
I don't think there's...
Yeah, there's other news. Nothing big. We can go through it.
You complained there wasn't enough news to talk about.
Well, there's nothing big.
There's the Microsoft appealing to the Supreme Court about the Xbox 360... scratches that apparently were happening. If you're playing Xbox 360, sometimes the games would scratch themselves, or the Xbox would seem to scratch. From what I understand, is whatever the court is, but below the Supreme Court ruled that it was in Xbox's, they had to pay out. And so Microsoft
is in the consumer's favor.
It was in the consumer's favor. Microsoft has appealed. Because apparently it was only 0.4% of all Xbox 360s that were sold.
Because they used a tray rather than
It's disc trays.
Rather than a roller to get the CD in.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
So,
thanks. Really needed
to
know.
So, Microsoft is appealing to overturn that ruling.
Yeah.
Cool.
Which, yeah.
But, yeah. So, that's the major...
there's other stuff, but it's not huge.
Yeah.
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 If you're in Europe, you get an extra one day of PS
Plus.
Yeah,
I saw that. You have just like, I'm imagining just like the Sony CEO, just like, you have 24 hours. Just like, you must.
It's like an egg press. It's like, this will explode.
Yeah. You have 24 hours.
There's
to
a ton of
the PlayStation Plus game you need.
There's a ton of people I've seen online who are like, "Is this real? Like one day? This seems fake." And there's a lot of people like, "No, it's real."
No.
There's eight hours out, and then people are like, "Really? Was that when we were sleeping?"
That's a pretty good like trade off though. Like lost 8 hours, get 24.
Well, I think Australians weren't even affected because I think it was like 1 and 9. AM our time.
Oh, wow.
Australians like PSM went out. What?
Good.
All right, well that's everything for...
I think that's all.
This week.
Yeah. That's it.
That's it.
We can be more controversial next time.
When I'm not here.
Yeah.
Next week you get to see Axton in this chair, or one of these chairs.
We'll
have new microphones. Remember to like, follow, and subscribe. You can see our Twitter name somewhere up here, down there, on our faces.
Yeah, but anyway.
All over Jonathan, maybe. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, look. Oh, here's mine. There it is.
And then we can just add a...
We had a whole episode without talking about Recall.
Recall!
Recall!
Okay, turn off.
Kill it all. Farewell.
How's it going?
This is
Double Dash Jump.
Jump.